गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर वेल। डियर पेरेंट्स, वी नीड योर सपोर्ट, काइंडली सबमिट योर वार्ड फीस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू आर वॉचिंग क्लास 7 साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 9 रेस्पिरेशन इन ऑर्गेनिज्म पार्ट 9। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट डियर स्टूडेंट्स। टेबल 9.3 शोज द सम डिफरेंस बिटवीन फोटोसिंथेसिस एंड द रेस्पिरेशन। नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टेबल डिफरेंस बिटवीन फोटोसिंथेसिस एंड रेस्पिरेशन। Dear student, photosynthesis, it is the process by which plants prepare their own food using carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. Dear student, that photosynthesis is a process in which plants prepare their food by the help of carbon dioxide, water and the sunlight and the chlorophyll. They prepare their own food as glucose. Dear students, it occurs during the daytime because sunlight is required. It occurs mainly in the green part of a plant such as leaves and stems where chlorophyll is present. Dear student, chlorophyll is necessary for the process of photosynthesis. A chemical reaction is, dear student, 6CO2 plus 6H2O gives presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, 6C6H12O6 plus 6O2. Now, dear student, come to the respiration. Dear student, respiration is a process in which breakdown of glucose using oxygen to form a carbon dioxide and water and energy. It is the process of breakdown of glucose using oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water to release energy. Dear students, it occurs both daytime and also nighttime. The exchange of gases takes place in the leaves, stems and roots. Cellular respiration takes place in all the cells in every part of a plant. Dear student, cellular respiration is in every part of a plant. An exchange of gases takes place in the leaves, stems and root. Now, chemical equation, dear students, for respiration, C6H12O6 plus 6CO2 gives carbon dioxide plus water plus energy. C6CO2 plus 6H2O plus energy. Now, dear students, come to activity. Aim: to prove that heat is released during the process of respiration. Now, material: the student, germinating seed, 2 conical flowers, 2 thermometer and 1 hole stopper. Now, dear students, now come to the procedure. Divide the germination seeds into a 2 equal portion. Boil one portion to stop further the germination. Dear students, next, transfer the boiled seed into a conical flask A. Transfer the germinating seed into a conical flask B. Sure that seeds are moist. Seeds should be moistened. Close the flask tightly with the stopper and insert a thermometer through the hole so that we can easily take the temperature. In each stopper, such the bulb of the thermometer is fully surrounded by the seed. Note initial temperature on each thermometer. Now, dear student, in this way we have to arrange the thermometer, boiled seed and the germinating seed. Now, dear student, leave the flask undisturbed for 24 hours and then record temperature of the seeds in each flask at the regular interval time or the 2 days. Dear students, time to time we have to take a temperature of both. Now, dear students, observation: temperature rises in conical B and the remains same in conical A. Conclusion: boiled seeds do not germinate as they do not alive, so the respiration takes place in the flask A. Because here respiration takes place. Germination seed in flask B are alive and they are carried out respiration. Due to respiration, heat is produced in the conical flask B that increase its temperature. Dear students, by this activity it is proved that due to respiration heat is produced in conical flask B. So because here the temperature is increased, so dear students, we prove that heat is released during the process of respiration. Now, dear students, filling the blanks using the word given in the box. First, the process of taking in oxygen rich air and giving out carbon dioxide rich air is, dear student, that is external respiration. Second is, student, in the human respiratory system, the exchange of gases takes place in the tiny sac in a lungs that is called, student, alveoli. Now, third is, student, the number of times of a person breathe in a minute is called the breathing rate. Now, fourth is, student, in blood, oxygen is transported in the form of compound that is called, student, oxyhemoglobin. Now, come to the fifth year, students. When glucose is oxidized in the presence of oxygen, and end products are carbon dioxide and water. So, dear student, you have to fill this, filling the blanks in your book. Thank you, student. Stay home. Be safe.